Unsolicited gyan is something which is not welcome nowadays. Without calling these the fundas of life, let me give you my own thought process on, can I share some of my own experiences with you, and maybe, you know, we can talk a little bit after that, okay? Everybody has a different experience in life. I graduated in 93. The economy of this country, 2016, very different from the economy of 1993. When I came out of college, economic reforms had just begun. People had started getting corporate jobs. I didn't even enter the corporate sector. I can't even tell you about that. But I can tell you about the basics of life and what I feel are the basic values. I can tell you about my learnings. And I can share with you today, with as much honesty as possible, what has helped me. So I'm just going to tell you 8 or 9 things which have helped me, and maybe we'll talk about that after that, okay? My first point which I'll share with you is, and these are my lessons to you students, just feel light today. Today you're going out into the world. Today you've got a professional degree. And the first thing you must know is, just jump into the unknown. You know what I mean, what I'm saying? Jump into the unknown. Close your eyes. Just jump. Don't be afraid. Do not sit with a piece of paper and say, I'm 22 years today. At 25, I'll be this, 27, this, 30, this, 35, 40. There was a film, you know, in which Shahid Kapoor would do that. It was called Kamine, and he used to write down exactly what he wanted to do, right down to when he got married. That's the stupidest thing to do. Feel light. I jumped into the unknown in May 2004. I had no idea how to launch a channel. I didn't know anything about it. Take the chance and jump. And I said, what's going to happen after that? They said, everything will sort out after that. If you want to do it, do you want to do it? I said, yeah, I want to do it. I want to launch a channel. Do you know anything about launching a channel? I said, no. You feel you can work hard for it? I said, I can. But one day, I just closed my eyes. I jumped into the unknown. And at that point of time, the head of Star TV India, Uday Shankar, I called him and I said, Uday, what should I do? He said, Arnab, and that's my second lesson to you. He said, fly solo. In life, you can't be part of a group all the time. You're part of a group, but what are you on your own? What if you fly solo? Just fly solo, and if you don't fly solo, you will never learn anything in life. When I look back, had I asked myself in 2004, had I been the guy in Kamine, writing everything, iske baad kya hoga, I would have never taken this risk. And again, I'm just telling you my learning in life. You know, disrupt. You must have heard this word all the time, right? You cannot be a winner by following what others have done. You will never win. Change the rules. Whatever you have learned, one day life will teach you something else. You must then step forward and say, I want to do things my own way. Disrupt something. For me, disruption was changing the rules of the TV industry. When I joined TV in 1995, I came into the room in NDTV and someone told me, golden rule of journalism. I said, what? Golden rule is never express your opinion. I said, really? And today, every night between 9 and 11, I only give my opinion. I just broke the rule. You will find, whether you're in banking or in any other sector in the future, maybe you'll get a chance to disrupt. So, and this worked for me, it may work for you. So the thing is, success is never on an Excel sheet. Okay? Like when you make a business, people, when they make a business, they make a business plan. Next 5 years, profits, losses, P&L sheet, we'll do this, we'll do that. When you start the business, everything goes for a toss. Then the business plan is only on paper. Everybody on paper can be a success. Believe me. On paper, you want me, I can write a business plan bigger than Apple today. But Steve Jobs didn't make Apple on an Excel sheet. Success is never on an Excel sheet. Success is in your gut. It's in your heart. The biggest companies, the greatest successes that I've heard of, known of, experienced. And even the success, the small and limited success of the channel which I have launched, which is a small success, has not happened on an Excel sheet. It's happened in the heart. Students, learn from your mistakes. Just learn from them. They are more valuable than anything in life. You will make mistakes. And very often, we don't learn from our mistakes, not because we don't know that we are wrong. We don't learn from our mistakes because we don't have the humility to accept that we were wrong. Sometimes we go horribly wrong. Learn from your mistake and have the humility to accept that you may be wrong. You may be the brightest and the best, and you may have learned from the best. But the day you learn to learn, pick up your mistake, not for anything else, but just for a life experience, you will end up becoming a better person and a better professional. Don't let your peers judge you. Don't let your peers judge you. If you're working in a bank, you're an assistant manager, don't compare. Don't, doesn't matter what they think of you. In my life, I have learned only one lesson. If you are free from peer pressure, you do well. And remember, they will not judge you well when you're doing badly. They will not judge you well when you're doing very well. Only you, only let your conscience judge you. To thine own self be true. Eventually, to myself, I have always believed you only need to be true to yourself. So be true to yourself. Don't accept peer pressure. Does not matter what your peers think of you. Always be independent. I'm not saying don't be loyal. Be loyal to your organization to which you work. You are a person in your own right. You are an individual. You will only succeed in life if you are completely independent. For me, independence is my independence as a journalist. I forever want to be independent. Do what you believe. Listen to no one and nobody. You see, what if you become very successful? Today, you have visions of where you want to be. Maybe some of you are saying, I want to be an assistant general manager by this time or a general manager by this time. Don't stagnate is very important. Okay? Don't stagnate. So when you're at the height of your career, do something to surprise yourself. Reinvent yourself at whenever you are at a peak. Every few years, you will find you're crossing a new peak. Just when you feel that life is going good, change your course. Because just when life is going good, the temptation comes to cruise along. And we all stagnate when we start cruising. Don't cruise. Reinvent yourself at the height of your career. And my last point to you, students, and I really wish you well. You are so young. You have so much optimism and hope. Is that, you know, think of the biggest thing which you can do and close your eyes. Close your eyes today. Go back. And a very close friend of mine, he and I talk a lot. And he told me, I said, how did you start your company? He started an advertising agency. He's one of the top in India today, completely independent. His name is Praveen Kenneth. He started Law and Kenneth. He said to me that, just sit down, close your eyes, take a piece of paper and a pen. And close your eyes. And just think of what the greatest thing that you can do in life. Not the most money you can make, not the quickest route, but the greatest thing you can do personally, which will really make you happy. If my life were to come down to this, this would be great fun. And then when you open your eyes, write it on the piece of paper and keep it somewhere. That's it. Everybody has to have a bigger dream in life. And don't be afraid of sharing it. Like, I have a big dream. I have a dream that in this country, in the next 3 or 4 years, independent global media corporations will start. I'm asking you, what is your dream? A dream which surpasses your next job. A dream which surpasses your next to next to next job. Right? A dream which surpasses more than anything else all the things that you felt were your limitations in life. Everybody feels they have a limitation in life. You know what my greatest limitation was? My greatest limitation was that I was not considered smart enough or good looking enough to be on TV 15 years back. I was told, you on TV? No, impossible. Impossible. And here I am. I'm just the same, but I'm okay. I'm on TV every night. What's your biggest dream, students? Ask yourself. Okay? I've shared my dream with you. Ask yourself your own individual dream. Trust me. That's the first step to getting there. Clarity of thought. So I've given enough fundas, I think, for the day. I hope it's been of some use to you. It's not what you classically learn, and I'm sorry if I disappointed you. But I hope that some of the things I shared with you today, which are my deep personal experience, will help you in this wonderful journey of life that you're going to go through. Are you excited? Are you guys excited or not today? Are parents and all, are they excited? If I were you, my God, 2016... the first years of my career from 2016 to 2036, my God, 2036 seems like the space age. We'll be too old by then. But you're going to be having a ball. So I wish you a lot of luck. Be confident. Be daring. Take risks. Remember, if you can, what I told you today. And more important than anything else, enjoy yourself. Because you're entering the most beautiful phase of your life. Thank you very much, students, for calling me today. Thank you. Thank you.